Guys, welcome back to the Independent Investor Channel. In this particular video, I'm going to take you guys into what I consider to be the premier marketplace for selecting your exchange-traded funds, referred to as ETFs. And just here recently, I've come across a lot of threads online really kind of using ETFs as a punching bag, you know, for, you know, why aren't you trying to outpace the market? Why aren't you seeking higher than average returns? And the sheer reality of it is that most people are looking to invest passively. They don't have a lot of time in their day-to-day lives to babysit their investments, and they're looking to get invested in the right place with the lowest cost associated. That is the reality that we live in, and ETFs provide that to most people. Guys, if it's your first time tuning into the Independent Investor Channel, I highly encourage you to subscribe to my channel. This channel is about putting individuals in charge of their own money. I show you what account to put your money in, and I show you what products to associate with that account. And with those two things, you can become powerful. And in essence, by doing those two things, you're really cutting out the middleman, which has been really historically tied to traditional methods of investing in the stock market. Most people think that you have to go seek out representation. And I've contended throughout the course and the life of this channel that is absolutely unnecessary. And with new products coming online, it's absolutely become more of a necessity that people really understand the totality of their options when it comes to making their investment decisions for themselves. So right now, guys, I'm actually going to take you into the Vanguard site, and I'm going to walk you through this listing of ETFs for you guys. I'm going to speak a little bit about each ETF and how they can be combined with each other to provide you diversification right off the bat. And it's also going to provide you guys an entry into the market in a safe, calculated, and strategic approach, in that you're not forced to have to take on more than average risk to somehow outpace the market, when all you really need to do is meet the market. So right now I'm gonna kick you into the Vanguard site, guys, and we're gonna get a little bit more in depth into the ETF offerings through Vanguard.
So I brought you guys into the Vanguard's ETF website here, and I've mentioned this many times through the channel, but I really wanted to have an opportunity to actually bring you in here and show you exactly what it is that I look at when I'm recommending these products. I don't recommend them for you as a particular investment option without doing a significant amount of research, but I also feel like we're doing a better job in offering transparency through the channel in actually showing you guys where this information comes from. In regard to the low expense ratio. We talk about that all the time. And you notice here in this column, these are the expenses that we're looking to identify as being the low expense in the industry. Okay? And I will offer this in the far right column. This is going to be your rate of return since inception. And I've seen a lot of threads online really kind of using ETFs to beat up and ask investors who may not understand or think that they're doing the right thing and ask the question why they're not looking to pursue a higher rate of return than what is offered through an ETF. And it can be extremely misleading to a new investor who doesn't quite understand that by going after this 8-9% rates of return year over year that you can meet your financial goals. And unfortunately, a lot of people will be subject to either putting their money into managed accounts, thinking that that management is giving them a strategic advantage, and it is not, okay? Or they will opt to take on a little bit more risk that is necessary to get this rate of return here. And there's a lot of misconception about the need to outpace the stock market. And everybody's talking about you can't beat the stock market by investing in ETFs. And that is true. What is not true is to not point out to starting investors is that ETF investing guarantees you to meet the market, okay? And there's a lot to be said about the value of meeting the market and making sure that your money is getting the maximum benefit out of itself as it compounds over time, and not taking setbacks within the account by not keeping pace or underpacing the market, okay? There was a thread that came through the Facebook group here recently talking about, it was from a financial planner, and it was basically, of course, beating up ETF investors and why they don't pursue a higher rate of return. And the example that was pushed through was that Dave Ramsey consistently beats the market by 5% every year. He openly advertised, "I beat the market, I beat the market." What's sometimes misleading about that message is that Dave Ramsey has a team of financial planners working behind the scenes to get that alpha for Dave, okay? And that commission or rate of fees that are being paid to those financial planners to get that extra alpha of 5% performance is not openly disclosed to the public, okay? So he's got this team of investors behind the scenes working so he can outpace the market by 5%, okay, only to turn around to people and say, "I beat the market by 5%, and not disclose how much they're paying those money managers behind the scenes who are working frivolously to create those 5 basis points of alpha in the stock market, as opposed to just looking at an ETF, putting it into your account, and forgetting about it. We are talking about 2 completely different approaches to the stock market. One, neither more right than the other, but one program is going to fit the majority of people, and the other program is probably going to affect the very few people in the stock market who want to take on a little bit more risk to try to get more reward in the stock market. And that's the misleading part about what people really don't understand, is that there is absolutely no maintenance that is required when you invest in an exchange-traded fund. There's no management required whatsoever. All that's really required is to put these into the very best account that is available to you. And on the Independent Investor Channel, we offer just that. If you combine the information on starting the self-directed Roth IRA account, and you combine that information with what I offer through starting as an ETF investor up to your first $10,000, it just doesn't get any better than that. And I would have absolutely been thrilled to come across this information if I was a new investor back when I started investing 25 years ago. I would have been thrilled to have these products available to me at a super low expense and a meeting rate of return that is healthy. A lot of the compounding calculators that we run on the Independent Investor Channel assume a rate of return of 7% on average in the stock market. You guys just kind of look here to the right. Look at some of the rates of returns in some of these funds since they were incepted back in 2006, 2004. Here's VTI, one of my favorites, in 2001. And a lot of people hit me up with, "Well, how many of each of these funds should be in my self-directed Roth IRA account?" And what I'd like to stress is that these are the 2 flagship accounts I recommend all the time. These are large cap ETF offerings. And what you need to do is, if you can click into this, first I'll go into the S&P 500 and kind of look at, you know, what I'm looking at here. This is 96% lower than the average expense ratio of funds with similar holdings. So you can kind of validate some of the data and analytics that I offer through the channel, and I thought it extremely beneficial to just go on here and just show you, with the goal of transparency on the channel, to actually show you so you don't have to just believe what I say. You can actually see it for yourself, and that's really where a lot of the value comes through the channel, is that I try to demonstrate that transparency to you guys. But if you look at this account here, started in 2010, we would have all over tripled our money in the S&P 500 over the last 8 years. But if you scroll down here, you can kind of see the top 10 holdings here, starting with Apple, Microsoft, Google, Amazon, Facebook, all companies that you've heard of, obviously. But then you kind of go back here, and I want to show you on a comparison basis. When I'm hit with the question, should I own VOO and VTI at the same time, you can easily see here that what we're trying to avoid is the overlap in the 2 accounts. And you can see here that the top five holdings are exactly the same. So, you know, I tend to try to build your large cap portfolio exposure with just one offering. You really just need to pick one. Now, make no mistake, every one of these funds are really, really good funds. You can meet your large cap exposure by either going with a high dividend yield offering, a mega cap growth offering, an S&P 500, or a total stock index, right? A large cap blend. Or a value ETF. Any of these will work for you, and you want to just kind of look at this product offering. And anybody out there that's interested in putting a product into their account that is more in line with their risk tolerance may opt to go with more of a dividend type of play, which is here, which has gained you 8% since 2006 on average. These are very safe, diversified funds. And another thing that was kind of missed on the message that came through the Facebook group in arguing against this is that all too often so many people want to say, why would you invest in the S&P 500? Why not just invest in, let's say, the S&P 600 to include the small cap offerings? And I offer this back. Most people want the safest route to go when they are investing their hard-earned dollars, okay? Remember that we're trying to wealth preserve dollars, okay? Not only tax protect, but to wealth preserve. So when we want to take this money, this S&P 500 account, and we put it into a self-directed account, it's going to act different than if you take that same ETF, same level of risk, and put it into a managed account, okay? Remember, you're taking the same amount of risk, but you're going to make less money in a managed account as opposed to putting it into a self-directed account, same level of risk, and allowing those two to be passive. Because in a managed account, they're taking your profits away from you, even though you own a product that is meant to be passive in nature. It's counterintuitive. It's counterproductive. What we're trying to do is align the stars so that you're putting these passive assets into an account that cost you little to nothing and allowing those dollars to grow unobstructed into the future. And so a lot of folks want to come in here and they want to say, well, why don't you invest in this fund? It beats the S&P 500 every year. Yes, but what is missed is the level of risk you are willing to take on by investing in more of a small cap offering as opposed to the large cap offering, okay? The level of risk you are taking on there to seek out a higher level of return when compared to the S&P 500 is greater. And that's what a lot of people miss. They say, why don't you invest in this fund over here? It outpaces. Yes, but I'm taking on more risk. With more risk comes more reward. And this is an appropriate vehicle for most people who want to just put their money into a low to no cost investment vehicle and allow it to work for them correctly into the future. If I could give that one gift to people over the Independent Investor Channel, it would be just that one gift, is that people need to understand that with the right account and the right investment products, they need zero investing experience. I will say it again, you need zero investing experience. And you'll have people with all kinds of noise who are way more elegant than me on selling their product to you that will chip away at that very fact and try to justify that you need to seek out their services to somehow seek out some sort of alpha in the stock market. And remember, outpacing is not necessarily what we need. Pacing the market at a respectable rate of return is what we are looking to get as we're looking to accumulate and grow wealth as safely and as efficiently and as fundamentally principled and ground as we possibly can. So guys, I really hope you enjoyed this offering. This is really where we come from when we're talking about some of the mid-cap offerings here. I just kind of want to premise here, you know, if we click into one of these mid-cap growths, here's an extended market ETF. You can click into any one of these on your own times, but I just wanted to kind of visually show you what it is that I kind of look at here. And this is a great example of how an ETF will perform over time, okay? And I want to remind you guys that during the 2008-2009 downturn, had you invested in this particular mid-cap fund, you would have started with $10,000. Your ETF would have been cut almost in half. you would have been down to $5,358. And without the proper training, most people would have panicked and they would have moved out of the market. Had you done that at this particular juncture right here, you would have missed out on these rates of return over the next 10 years, almost tripling your initial investment of $10,000 to $29,062. Guys, that is the very power and essence of the ETF. You've done it diversified. You've tripled your money with very, very little to minimal cost and expense. And if you had housed this particular asset within your self-directed account, you would have realized all of this tripled profit in that account without sharing it with any money managers trying to sell you a program and sell you on the fact that you need to pay them and that you need to seek out that representation to have an advantage over the stock market. Products like these make that interaction unnecessary in today's investing landscape. You just don't need to do it. So guys, I'm going to kick you back over without further ado for the closing of this YouTube video. Very important offering, and I just wanted to show you guys and highlight some of the functions of this Vanguard website. You can go in here and you can research the totality of these products on your own, and you can pick whatever products are going to kind of meet your risk tolerance. Guys, there is no right portfolio and there is no wrong portfolio. These funds are really the best of the best. And however you pick these and however you allocate these in your portfolio or your investment account, your retirement account, make no mistake, the only thing you're really looking to do is avoid overlap in your account. That's really all you're looking to do. And I will close with this. In most of your retirement accounts, I get asked all this all the time, do I have to have a Vanguard account to buy Vanguard ETFs? And the answer is absolutely not. You can have a Fidelity account, you can have a TD Ameritrade. I've traded Vanguard ETFs within my Merrill Edge account. You can have these put into your M1 finance account if that's the avenue you guys choose to go through. And another good takeaway I will close on this is if you start these ETFs within your retirement account, you will be able to set these up for dividend reinvestment within your retirement account free of charge, all right? So guys, without further ado, I will kick you back to YouTube for the closing of this ETF video. Thank you so much for tuning in.
Guys, welcome back. We're just come back out of the Vanguard ETF site. I really hope you've enjoyed. You know, I talk about the ETFs all the time. People really just don't understand to put it together. And I really just wanted to put the information in front of you guys so there was no confusion at all as to where I do my ETF offerings, where I seek that out, where that analytics and data come from. You guys can get on there and you can identify for yourself what each and every one of those offerings offer to yourself. And then using the M1 product to build your guys' ideal portfolios in accordance with your own risk tolerance, guys, it's going to empower each and every one of you guys who hear the message and dare to dream and deploy some of this information in your own lives. Guys, thank you so much for tuning into the Independent Investor Channel. If you guys know anybody out there who's looking to get involved in the stock market, you have to refer them to the channel. We offer rock solid advice along the lines of empowering individual investors and doing so by eliminating or drastically reducing fees within your retirement accounts. Keep in mind that ETF investing is a diversified way of investing passively over the long term. And guys, you'll have people try to argue this point up and down, but it is really the tried and true, tested best way to invest in the stock market over the long term. Guys, thank you so much for tuning into this message and good luck in your investment future.